individuals, the leaders of a new breed of Australian bands who got the influence from a rock culture shock.
How important do you think then the sort of the punk, then the new wave explosion was to music in the latter of the 70s?
A very important enema.
Say someone like the Sex Pistols, when they had all that outrageous publicity in that about being dropped from different companies, what was your opinion on that when it was all happening, if you had an opinion?
The only thing is that it was a shame that it all got manufactured so quickly, in a way. It would have been nice if they'd come out on a really sort of a hardy independent label, I thought.
Right.
It's a shame that they jumped for those great giant idiots, because, I mean, that's the perfect step not to take.
It's just come out of frustration, I think, as I said before, you know, saying that we wanted something to happen, definite to happen. And I think it did. I think it was very positive in the end. People say it was negative, but I think it was very positive.
I thought that the whole thing was really just like a game, you know? It was just like a big business game. The business people were saying, oh, no, we don't want them. And they're going, we. You know, it was all people acting and becoming roles and playing their roles.
I was expected to live up to the press.
And did you?
No.
Well, take for instance...
That's why I was disliked.
Well, take for instance...
I would not be a puppet, I will not act out somebody else's pantomime.
Well, I mean, if you listen to the music, that's the enthusiasm for me, you know. The music's really good rock and roll.
Right.
And a lot of other people try it, but it took kids like that and the energy that they could bring to it to really rock out kind of thing. So I think that's the big thing for them. I mean, I don't go for the publicity and stuff, because that was always doomed from the start, you know, just overkill, and that. I feel sorry for them in that way, because, I don't know, it sort of did them in. But the music is just all I listen to, and it's really good music if you give it a listen.
I don't think they've been very influential at all, musically, but I think probably they've opened a lot of doors for bands that came along after them.
Yeah, I loved the principle behind it all. I never really pretended to understand what was going on. I can't pretend that I understand. I'm 28 and I can't pretend that I understand 18-year-olds writing songs about being on the dole and living in high-rise council blocks of flats and being underprivileged and deprived. I can't pretend to understand that because it's not part of my lifestyle, so I won't lie and say, oh, I'm hip to that, because I'm not. I'm from another world. Well, what the Pistols did and their ilk was important in that they made it very obvious that anyone can do it.
In England, they charge like $12 to $15 to $20 for a ticket to see a rock group play. And in America, it wasn't quite that expensive. And plus, we were able to, you know, to afford that a lot easier than the British were at the time. And so the punk rock bands and all those people came out, they started charging like $3, $4 a ticket, and that was it. And it's got to do with that, plus it was just a lot of rebellion in it. And I just don't think that the American taste is really, I mean, Americans are really into like being strong and things like that, but I don't think a very violent thing like that.
Well, I mean, that was maybe a form of rebellion, rebellious whatever, for whatever reason. I mean, but when it starts getting violent and everything, then it can't be good.
What do you think got into Sid to do what he did?
I don't know. He always used to say all the time he's going to die before he's 21, and I just suppose he wanted to die. I don't know.
The whole punk thing, which is the mainstay of energy pack rock and roll at the moment over here in Great Britain anyway, it's only happening like in the last 3 or 4 years, and then only successfully for the last couple of years. I mean, I'm talking about people like Police and Squeeze and Boomtown Rats, who are really, really good bands. Now, to see whether they'll have any lasting effect, we've got to wait till like mid-80s to let some time go by. I mean, even the Boomtown Rats have had, what, 3 or 4 hits? Well, it's hardly time to be able to say that these guys are going to have some great everlasting influence.
And once all those musicians go through their experimental periods, their psychedelic periods, and God knows what else, and become rich and fat, then the new lean and hungry will kick them out, and so the cycle moves on.
The punks, you know, and they started got the energy. They got the energy back on, you know. Musically, they were a little off because some of them couldn't tune up, you know, which didn't help things too much, but the energy was there. And what they were saying, you know, it got a little political, but it had that, that didn't have all the elements of it, but it was starting. And then all of a sudden, something very strange happened called disco.
I don't know whether we made it respectable or not. I don't think that's the right word. I think we made it more popular.
You didn't like this?
Oh, letter? With a passion. I hated it.
Yeah.
Couldn't think of anything redeeming. It was old people's music,
right.
You know. And it was, I mean, you could go to a supermarket and go shopping, and you'd hear that music on. You might as well be.
So it was sort of more like a music thing.
Oh, I hated it. Well, I couldn't find anything that I liked about it, except that it got the parents out of the house.